Hi, my name is Chelsea.
And my name is Savannah.
Created a self-love manifesto, which is made up of 10 points that we think are really, really important when it comes to taking care of yourself. The first point is something that Savannah is always, always, always telling me about, but I never listen.
And it's knowing your limits.
Right.
You need to know, you need to find out what your breaking point is and to know not to go past that. Like, if you have 5 things lined up and you know you're only going to have time for those 5 things, do not say yes to a 6th one.
See, she's looking at me like that because I always do this. And I need to stop, obviously, because it gets to a point where I'm just constantly overwhelmed. And I don't feel accomplished when I finish one thing because the pile is just the same. You know, it's not like I finish one thing and I have one less thing to do. I just have the same amount of things to do.
That's it. So, you gotta know when to stop.
The second part is the rest. I'm still not good at this.
Not at all.
But I love taking naps, so.
Rest is super important. It's the one way your body has its downtime to recuperate from all the stress and all the anxiety and all the pain it's been through in a day, in a week, in a month, and if you don't rest, your body doesn't have a chance to relax in order for it to be able to handle the next day. So our third point is to eat.
And drink water.
Yeah.
And by eat, sometimes, you know, like sometimes I'll go to the bakery and get like a dessert because I really just need that ounce of sugar.
Yeah.
But then when we say eat, it's also important to like eat fruits, veggies, eat a meal, and you know, like pack it in with water. Not drink wine, not drink juice, drink water.
Yeah.
You hear that?
No, I don't understand.
Not coffee, not tea, just, you know, like buy a bottle of water, open your tap, just water.
Yeah.
Number 4, it's something that we do a lot, is talk to someone. And we've been friends for 4 years now, and it's very easy for me to, you know, it's very easy for me to talk to you.
Yeah.
And if I'm, you know, just basically feeling miserable, it's very easy for me to be like, hey, this is what's going on. So I think for this step, you need to talk to someone that you've built a relationship with. Not a stranger, not someone you've known for 2 weeks, but someone that can actually help you.
Yeah. This kind of leads us into our 5th point, which is release. And by release, we mean anything that gives you some sort of pleasure, like making art. I, for one, I like to write poetry, so that's my kind of release. Or
draw.
Yeah.
Or read. Oh my god, 2 weeks ago? No, let's say 3 weeks ago, I was having like deadlines, just everything was piling on. And I was at the library to meet someone. So I went, picked up my favorite book. I was like, I have no time to read this, but I have it. And, you know, I know your limit. But, you know, like I would be doing work and just tell myself, you know what? I'm done with this. Take my book and just read. It made me so happy.
Because everyone needs downtime. Right. You know what I mean? Like you need a little distraction from everything that's going on.
Do the thing that you love. Even if you do it for 5 minutes. You know, like if you like to draw, just take some time to like doodle. I feel like that would really just help.
It's like a balancing thing, right? Like
right. And the thing with release is that even if you do just five minutes of something you love, you'll feel so much better. This means even if you just like doodle stick figures, you will feel better, guaranteed. Number 6
is switching off, and I am such an advocate of this. I do it so often. I find it super productive. Social media gets to be a lot. Social media gets to be a lot. News gets to be a lot. Just sometimes life gets to be a lot. And by switching off, by turning off your phone, your TV, just yeah, kind of coming back to who you are, like that, I feel like that's so alleviating and so like mentally stimulating at the same time.
And then from switching off, you get to take a step back and reflect. That's our 7th point. But reflecting, it's really important because there's so many things that are positive around you, but you can't really see them when you're constantly being bombarded with all this information. So with number seven, just look around and see the things that you are thankful for. You know, like, are you thankful for your friendships? Are you thankful for the city you live in, the season? Are you thankful for the sun being out?
And I don't know, just be thankful every morning that you get the chance to wake up and have a new opportunity to do a new day.
Right. It sounds cliche, but there are positive things in your life. Like, you are lucky to a certain extent, and it's nice to reflect on that and to say thank you.
This kind of goes into number eight, which is just to get out of bed and do something. And that's important because sometimes when you're sad and when you're not feeling well, like, you feel literally bounded to your bed. Like, I don't want to leave here because I'm just so, you know, not okay that I just want to stay here forever. But if you make that one step, that's a hard step, just to get out of bed. And whether it's just going outside and taking, like, walking around the block just to get some fresh air, just to re-stimulate, like, reorganize your thoughts and how you feel.
Yeah.
Already that makes the difference.
Yeah, definitely. Number nine is something that I started doing very recently. It's admit when you're happy. Not enough people, at least not enough people that I know, admit when they're happy. Yeah. And what happens now is that if someone asks me, how are you? And I say, I'm happy. Like, I had it once, my friend. I said, I'm happy. And she started laughing.
Yeah.
Because we don't say it enough that when people hear it, they're like,
it's almost uncomfortable to hear that someone else is happy, you know?
You kind of want someone to be like, well, this and this and this and this are wrong, and then you can help them. But once they say they're happy, it's like, well, okay.
It's also like kind of a subconscious rut. Like, if you say you're unhappy and then I say I'm unhappy and then we're just kind of unhappy and
swimming in unhappiness.
Yeah, it kind of sets a vibe, and then you can't, like, it doesn't really give you the motivation to want to be better.
But, like, with being happy too, it doesn't mean everything in your life is working perfectly. It just means you feel good. So sometimes, let's say I have a paper due tomorrow and I have not started, but I'm still happy. Mm-hmm. And I take a step back and I'm like, wow, it feels good to be happy.
Yeah. Number 10.
She's very good at number 10.
I'm an expert. And that is putting yourself first. It's so important to recognize that if you are not well, if you are not taking care of yourself and putting your needs first, you're not going to be able to do the things you want to do. You're not going to be able to meet your deadlines. You're not going to be able to help other people if you're not able to help yourself.
Right. You know? And that's really true, because you basically, you can't even help yourself unless you take care of yourself. Right?
Yeah.
And I find that with all these points, number 10 is really, really important, just because you need to understand number 10 to be able to do the other ones, you know, like, if you don't put yourself first, will you ever make time for you to eat, for you to rest, for you to do what you love? So this sums up our 10 points on self-love, that we're not experts at all of them,
but we're working on it,
right? And it's just a continuous, like, when you feel bad, just refer to this and be like, okay, I'm going to go through each and every one of these steps, and you're guaranteed to feel better. Just doing one of these will help you feel better.
Guaranteed.